Faith. What is it? Being sure of our hope. Convinced of what we can't see. By faith, we understand the world was set in order at God's command. By faith, Abel offered God a greater sacrifice than Cain, and for his faith, God commended him as righteous. By faith, Noah trusted God and constructed an ark for the deliverance of his family. By faith, Abraham was willing to sacrifice Isaac, his only son, believing God would still fulfill his promises. By faith, Moses chose to be mistreated with the people of God rather than enjoy sin's fleeting pleasure. By faith, God's chosen nation crossed the Red Sea on dry ground and praised him as it swallowed up the Egyptians. By faith, Rahab the prostitute escaped destruction because she welcomed the spies in peace. Time will fail me if I tell you of Gideon, David, and the prophets. By faith, they administered justice, shut the mouths of lions, quenched raging fire. But others were imprisoned, murdered, and wandered in deserts, mountains, and openings in the earth. We are surrounded by this great cloud of witnesses. So get rid of every weight of every sin and run. Run with endurance the race set before us. Keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. He is the champion and guide of our faith. For promised joy, he endured the cross, thought nothing of its shame, and having risen again, has been handed his deserved glory at the right hand of the throne of God. We hope that your faith has been increased through this series. Welcome to Unshakeable Faith with Lady Barbara Golder.
All right, the study of Daniel's prayer life is extremely motivational. As we study the amount of faith that Daniel had, it's very motivational, and it encourages all Christians who desire greater faith and a better communion and communication with God. So before we get into our series, I want us just to pray God's anointing and his blessing upon tonight's lesson. So won't you bow your heads and pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this evening's class. We thank you, God, that you have helped us to work through all of the technical difficulties. And we thank you that there will be no more hindrances in tonight's session, and that, Lord, your word will go forth with power and conviction, God, and that people will be encouraged, that their faith will be strengthened, God, that your saints will be motivated. And, Lord God, that they will be, Lord, willing to do your will and to be obedient to your word. God, we thank you for all of the lessons that you'll teach us through the life of Daniel tonight. And we thank you, God, that you will give us the strength to bring forth your word in the way that pleases you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen and amen. All right, as we delve into this character, this Daniel character, we clearly see how his unshakable faith caused him first great adversity. But then we see how his faith also gained him great advancement. Through Daniel's life, we are able to glean several things. And I want you to get your paper and your pen out because you're going to need to know what these things are. All right? We're able to understand, number one, that obedience to God is an important part of answered prayer. Through Daniel's life, we're also able to see that prayer must be consistent and prayer must be genuine. We can't pray out of a sense of obligation. We can't pray out of a sense of tradition, and we sure can't pray out of a sense of legalism. All right, prayer has to come from your heart. It has to be consistent, but yet it has to be genuine. All right, number three, prayer is very powerful when it's done in unity. There's power in unity prayer. Some things, women of travail that we pray for and pray about. We need the presence of intercessors. We need other prayer warriors to touch and agree and go with us in prayer in order to get some things accomplished. We learned this through Daniel. Number four, there's power in private prayer. Listen, don't ever underestimate the power of your personal private prayer. God hears your prayer. God answers your prayer. There's power in your prayer. All right, number five, there's power in public prayer. No, we do not pray to be seen. But I've said it all along and I'll say it again. The world needs to see God's people praying. The world needs to see us reverencing God. The world needs to see us in worship. The world needs to see us crying out before God. We don't do it to be seen, but the world needs to see us. Number six, when we do God's will, God will always cause us to rise to the top. Even in the face of adversity, the saints will rise when we do his will. Number seven, delayed answers do not mean denied prayers. There's an old song, gospel song that they used to sing when I was a child, and it said, he may not come when you want him, but he's always on time. Can you just shout right where you are right now and just say, he's an on-time God. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's an on-time God. May not come when I think he should. But as I look back over my life, he's always been right on time. We learned that. It's shown to us through the life of Daniel. All right, Daniel chapter 1. I hope you have your Bibles, and we'll be reading Daniel chapter 1, and we're going to kind of skip around. We'll be reading in between verses 1 and 22. We won't read every verse, but of course you can go back and read it in its entirety once class is over. But right now, I want you to go to Daniel chapter 1 and verse 1. Daniel chapter 1 and verse 1. And the word of God reads, in the third year of the reign of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, came Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, unto Jerusalem and besieged it. Verse 3. And the king spake unto Ashpenaz, the master of his eunuchs, that he should bring certain of the children of Israel, and of the king's seed, and of the princes. Verse 5. And the king appointed them a daily provision of the king's meat, and of the wine which he drank, so nourishing them 3 years, that at the end thereof they might stand before the king. But Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with the portion of the king's meat. We're in verse 8. Nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore he requested of the prince of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. Now let's jump to verse 18. Now at the end of these days that the king had said he should bring them in, then the prince of the eunuchs brought them in before Nebuchadnezzar. Verse 20. And in all manners of wisdom and understanding that the king inquired of them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers that were in all the realm. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. Here we see that the Babylonians, they overthrew Jerusalem and took all of the young, all of the strong, all of the intelligent, all of the handsome males back to Babylon. And Daniel was among those that were captured. And history records that Daniel was right around between 10 and 14 years old. So he was a very young man, but he was a bright young man. And he loved God even at a young age. Now, the king had a hidden agenda. He knew that leaving the old people and leaving all of the older women in Jerusalem posed no threat. And he intended to use the brightest and the best that Jerusalem had to offer in order to expand his kingdom. The king knew the importance of a good diet, even though, according to scripture, we know that he might have known the importance of a good diet, but he didn't know what a good diet really was. But the Bible says that the king provided the captives with food from his table so that they could be well nourished and so that they could operate at peak. But scripture says that Daniel would not eat from the king's table. He refused to eat the king's food because he refused to defile his body. So what might the king have been offering to Daniel? Well, let's think about it today. What might the king have been offering? I can see on the king's table, there may have been some barbecued ribs falling off the bone, smothered in barbecue sauce with some French fries to go with it. Would you have refused the king's table? I can see maybe at the king's table, it may have been some deep fried pork chops with rice and smothered gravy. That sounds good, don't it? Would you have refused the king's table? Could have been foods that weren't kosher. They weren't prepared the right way according to biblical law. But in any case, Daniel refused to consume things that were in direct disobedience to what God had commanded the people of God to eat. All of these things that we just mentioned would have been in direct disobedience to God and would have defiled Daniel's body. So we see the Bible tells us that instead, Daniel requested to eat pulse. Now, what is pulse? Pulse are beans and lentils and nuts and grains. And he said, I just want to drink water and vegetables. And so, you know what? You ought to know what pulse is, and you ought to know all about Daniel's diet, because we just came off of the Daniel's fast. Now, for Daniel, it wasn't a fast. For Daniel, it was a way of life. It was his diet. It was the way he ate. But for us, it was a fast. So the way that we ate when we went on the 40-day Daniel fast is the way that Daniel ate. Now, here again, I need you to take special note, because you will need this later. You will need this later. This is the first time that we see Daniel's unshakable faith in the face of death. Why? Because you see, Daniel, he could have been killed for refusing the king's food. But Daniel had the unshakable faith and trust in God. And even though his life was at stake, and even though he was in a strange land, and even though he was around strange people and strange customs, Daniel did not give in. And because of his faithfulness, the Bible says that in all matters of wisdom and in all matters of understanding, Daniel was found 10 times better than all of the magicians and astrologers that were in Babylon. People of God, the message here is that we have to stand for something or we'll fall for anything. Scripture lets us know that we are in the world, but we are not of the world, and our citizenship is in heaven. Therefore, we must stand in the face of compromise. We must stand for what's right, even when wrong is being celebrated. We must stand for holiness, even when we are considered strange and peculiar people. We cannot accept everything that the world serves us up. We must have unshakable faith and believe that God will reward us for our obedience and for our sacrifice. Somebody shout, I got some reward coming. Come on, don't you believe it? Not only is your reward in heaven, but we got some reward down here on earth. God will reward your faithfulness. Turn to Daniel chapter 2, and we're going to read verse 16. We'll read verses 16 through 19. Daniel chapter 2, verses 16 through 19. The word of God says, "Then Daniel went in and desired of the king that he would give him time and that he would show the king the interpretation. Then Daniel went to his house and made that thing known to Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, his companions, that they would desire mercies of God of heaven concerning this secret, that Daniel and his fellows should not perish with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. Then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the God of heaven." Here, women of Travail, is the second time that we see Daniel's unshakable faith in the face of death. Scripture says that the king had a troubling dream and he was going to kill all of the magicians and the astrologers, including Daniel, because they could not interpret his dream. The wise men, they even went so far as to say, "Only a God could interpret your dream, king." The Bible says that when Daniel heard about his fate, he asked the king to give him some time. And he said, "If you'll give me time," he said, "King, I will interpret your dream." Then the Bible says that Daniel went home and Daniel called a prayer meeting. Daniel went to his friends who he knew could get a prayer through. They asked God for mercy. And they asked God for revelation. And the Bible says that the secret was revealed to Daniel in a night vision. And then Daniel blessed God. Women of Travail, this is the power of unity prayer. When your back is up against a wall, when death is knocking at your door, when the enemy is accusing you, and when he's attacking you, when all hell is breaking loose in your life, you better have a nucleus of people in your life who you know will stop at the drop of a dime and go to God in prayer on your behalf. You gotta have people in your life that will cry out to God for mercy and for revelation. Listen, I thank God for the women of Travail. Women who realize the urgency of prayer. Women who are committed to a lifestyle of prayer. I thank God for this army of intercessors who will cry out to God for people that they don't even know. Thank God for a group of holy women who will not just say that they will pray, but they will be dedicated to a lifestyle of prayer. Daniel told the king, "I will interpret your dream. Just give me some time to get with the intercessors. Just give me some time to get in the face of God. I'll get you an interpretation to your dream." Daniel had unshakable faith in God. Turn to Daniel chapter 6, and we're going to read verses 3 and 4. Daniel chapter 6, verse 3. "Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and princes, because an excellent spirit was found in him. And the king thought to set him over the whole entire realm. Then the presidents and the princes sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom. But they could find no occasion, nor could they find any fault. For as much as he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him." Now, history records that Daniel was in charge of all of the wise men. Daniel was in charge of all of the functionary officials, the bureaucrats, the employees, all of the employees of the king. Daniel was set over all of them. Daniel was a loyal servant to the king, but he always put his God first. Daniel didn't violate any of God's laws, even though they were not the laws of the land that he was living in. Listen, when you are faithful to God, I promise you, God will be faithful to you. Turn to 1 Peter chapter 5. 1 Peter 5, and we're going to read, let's read verses 8, 9, and 10. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 8, 9, and 10. It says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour, whom resist steadfast in faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that you have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. WOT, we will be tested. It's part of the turf. We will be tried. We will be plotted against. People will be jealous of you. People will hate you, and people will try to destroy you. But God will grace you. God will strengthen you. God will establish you, and God will settle you. God will perfect you. Just be steadfast in your faith. Resist the devil, and don't stop praying. Don't ever stop praying. Daniel 6 and verse 7. It says, all of the presidents of the kingdom, the governors, the princes, the counselors, and the captains have consulted together to establish a royal statute and to make firm decree that whosoever shall ask a petition of any god or man for 30 days, save thee, O king, he shall be cast into the den of lions. Here, women of Travail, is the third time. Somebody say the third time. Write it down. The third time that we see Daniel's unshakable faith in the face of death. The regularity of Daniel's prayer life was so consistent that everybody who knew Daniel, they also knew that he faithfully prayed three times every day, because prayer was a part of Daniel's lifestyle. Therefore, we see in scripture that his enemies chose prayer to be the very focal point of their attack against Daniel. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, that he couldn't do any of his prayers to his God, the Bible says that Daniel went into his house, and his windows being open in his chamber toward Jerusalem, he kneeled upon his knees three times a day and prayed and gave thanks before God. Scripture reveals that even though Daniel knew that it may cost him his very life, he refused to stop praying. Although Daniel realized the value of private prayer, he refused to pray in secret. The Bible says that Daniel continued to pray with his windows open three times a day. Listen, Daniel could see the spies outside the window. Daniel could see his haters peering in. Daniel knew they'd take the report back to the king. He knew it could cost his life, but Daniel never stopped praying. Daniel continued to give thanks to his God. Turn to Daniel chapter 6, and we're going to jump all the way down to verse 16. We'll read verses 16, 17, and 18. Daniel 6 and 16, and it reads, "Then the king commanded, and they brought Daniel, and they cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spoke and said unto Daniel, thy God, whom thou servest continually, he will deliver thee." Underline that. That's the king talking. That's the pagan king talking about Daniel's God. Woo! That ought to make somebody shout right there. The power of your faithfulness is transferable. Verse 17, and a stone was bought and laid upon the mouth of the den, and the king sealed it with his own signet and with the signet of his lords, that the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel. Then the king went to his palace and passed the night fasting. Neither were there instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep went from him. Here we see that Daniel's unshakable faith was so impactful that it actually transferred on to this pagan king. We know this because the king told Daniel that God would deliver him. That's number one. Number two, we know this because the king fasted. He didn't eat anything that night. We know this because the king went into a solemn assembly of sorts. He refused music and entertainment. Fourthly, we know this because the Bible says the king stayed up all night. Now, may I submit to you that these were probably all things that the king witnessed Daniel doing in times of intense prayer and in times of Daniel's consecration. So the king was doing what he learned and saw Daniel do. Listen, there's a little word here that ain't even in my notes. And I hear God saying, people will do what they see you do before they do what you tell them to do. That's a good word. Some of us have been preaching and teaching and hollering so long, but our lifestyles do not match up to what we preach. Our lifestyles are not in alignment with what we teach. So people won't listen to us because they don't see any fruit. People will do what they see you doing way before they'll do what you tell them to do. Go to Daniel chapter 6 and verse 19. And we're going to read verse 23. How are you going to tell your children not to drink and they see you sipping? How are you going to tell your kids not to smoke and they see you puffing? How are you going to tell them don't cuss around me and every other word out of your mouth is a cuss word? They'll do what they see done before them. Clean it up. Come on, women of Travail. Somebody shout, I got to clean it up. I got to clean it all the way up so that I can be a good example and that others can follow me as I wear my hoodie next week that says unshakable faith like me, whatever my name is. Daniel chapter 6, verse 19. We'll read 19 through 23. All right, let's read that. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste into the den of lions. Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God has sent his angel and hath shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me. For as much as before him innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt. Then was the king exceeding glad for him and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den and no manner of hurt was found upon him because he believed in his God. Somebody say, I believe in my God. Go, glory. I believe in my God. Listen, God sent an angel to lock the jaws of the lions. WOT, you've got to understand that your faith will dispatch angels to lock the jaws of cancer. Your faith will dispatch angels to lock the jaws of diabetes. Faith will lock the jaws of COVID-19. Faith will lock the jaws of addiction. Faith will lock the jaws of depression. Faith will lock the jaws of fear. Your faith will lock the jaws of the devil and render him powerless. Unshakeable faith in God. Daniel chapter 10. We're going to go all the way down to verse 12. We're going to read verses 12 through 14. Daniel 10, verses 12 through 14. Then said he unto me, "Fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou hast set thine heart to understand, and to chasten thyself before thy God, thy words were heard. And I am come for thy words." Underline that. He's come for thy words, not for thy thoughts, not for thy intentions, not for thy emotions. He's come for your words. "But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 21 days. Lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, and I remained there with the kings of Persia. Now I am come to make thee understand what shall befall thy people in the latter days. For yet the vision is for many days." Here, through Daniel's experience, we are able to see exactly what happens when the righteous pray. The Word of God shows us that delayed answers to prayers are not denied prayers. In this passage of Scripture, Daniel knew from reading the words of the prophet Jeremiah that Jews would return to the homeland after 70 years of captivity in Babylon. At this time of this story and this scripture, it was the end of the 70-year period. And so Daniel was now inquiring of God, how will this transition, how will our freedom take place? When will it happen? How will it happen? I need some revelation, God. Now we see in Scripture that the very first time that Daniel prayed, God heard his words. Women of Travail, whenever you pray, whenever you speak words to God, God always hears them. Don't ever underestimate whether God is hearing you. You might feel like your prayers are hitting the ceiling and bouncing back down, but listen, God hears your prayer. Don't ever underestimate that. Don't ever doubt that. God hears your prayer. The next point is for everyone who likes to go to prayer meeting and be quiet. You need to understand that when you pray, you need to open your mouth and speak words. Your words set the course of action. Your words have the power of life. And your prayer was not designed to be quiet. Your prayer was designed to speak words. Listen, even God spoke words. He spoke the world into existence. And if God spoke words, you need to speak some words. It's time out for coming to prayer meeting, laying on your belly and being quiet. It's time to wail before God. It's time to travail before God. It's time to say some words. Some. 33:6. The Bible says, "By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the host of them by the breath of his nostril." People of God, when you pray, open your mouth and speak. Every part of you should be involved in prayer. Your tears pray. God interprets them. Your emotions pray. God feels them. Your body prays. Your your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Don't be silent any longer. Open your mouth. Cry out. Cry long and cry hard to the Almighty God in prayer. Now we understand that God heard Daniel's prayer. And he sent the angel Gabriel to answer Daniel's request. But the devil came against Daniel. The Bible says he withstood Gabriel for 3 whole weeks. Then the Bible says that God sent Michael, the archangel, the warring angel, if you will, to release Daniel's prayer request. Women of Travail, I pulled out this scripture because I needed you to understand that there are enemy forces that are working night and day. They're working overtime to try and come for your words. It's called spiritual warfare. That's why you have got to be careful and watch the words that come out of your mouth. When you speak idle words, when you speak negative words, when you speak words of defeat, when you speak words of destruction, the enemy comes for those words. And he comes this time to ensure that they come to pass. And when you pray, it's no different. The enemy comes. But this time he comes to block the manifestation of your words and your prayers. But I praise God for his warring angels who fight for us and who make sure that our prayers are answered. Finally, scripture never said that Daniel got discouraged because his prayers were held up 2-3 weeks. Scripture never says that Daniel began to doubt. Scripture never says that Daniel began to lack in his trust in his Almighty God. Scripture never says that Daniel stopped praying. No, Daniel kept right on praying. Because of Daniel's relentless, unshakable faith, Daniel's life was full of divine revelation. Because of Daniel's faith, his life was laced with miracles. Because of Daniel's faith, his life was full of signs and wonders. People of God, your faith will be challenged. Your faith will be tested. Your faith will come under attack. But you must be like Daniel and assume the attitude that no matter what the day may bring, I trust God. Won't you just say it with me right now? I trust God. Come on, say it again. I trust God. Pain wrecking my body, but I trust God. The doctors have given a negative report, but I trust God. Things are looking mighty grim around the world, but I trust God. Children are acting crazy, but I trust God. Come on, no matter what the day may bring, I trust God. God bless you, women of God. Go in grace and peace. And until next week, our last Unshakeable Faith series, I challenge you to press into God like never before. Allow him to grow your faith. And whatever the enemy throws your way, have unshakable faith in God. God bless you.
Thank you for tuning in to Women of Travail. For merchandise such as the Faith Like hoodies and to stay updated with Women of Travail and the Face Down Prayer Movement, please visit our website at www.wotfd.com. If you were blessed by the word, please like our page, share our content, and donate via Cash App at Barbara A. Golder, Givelify at Women of Travail Face Down, or through the donate option on our website, WOTFD.com. Join us for weekly prayer via Facebook Live every Thursday at 8 p.m. sharp Eastern Standard Time. We appreciate all of your support. See you next week via Facebook Live on Tuesday at 8 p.m. sharp for the next lesson of the Unshakeable Faith series. Thanks again for tuning in.